delighted to welcome you all to our festival performances. To our parents who have been particularly supportive through the year. To all the staff members who have worked so diligently. And most of all to our students who have eagerly prepared for tonight's event. This is a special day in our school calendar, and although we are staging a virtual ceremony, we are sure that it will be just as memorable an occasion. We invite you now to switch off, put up your feet, and enjoy the magical performance that reflects on the true meaning of Christmas. Enjoy.
Light a candle for all the newly born, and especially those who were baptized in our community during 2021.
The Child of Bethlehem calls us all to a deep respect for all human life, for all life is created by God in His image. Child of Bethlehem, draw near.
Child of Bethlehem, hear our prayer.
wspólnych członków rodziny i przyjaciół. Wspominamy ich życzliwością i miłością w tym okresie Adwentu. Niech ich duże spoczywa w pokoju kochających ramionach drugiego Dzieciątka Jezusa. Child of Bethlehem, draw near.
Child of Bethlehem, hear our prayer.
We light a candle for family members and friends who have died. We remember them with fondness and love in the season of Advent.
May their souls rest in peace in the loving arms of precious baby Jesus.
Child of Bethlehem, draw near.
Child of Bethlehem, hear our prayer.
Continue to work and volunteer tirelessly throughout this coronavirus pandemic.
We thank them for their kindness and bravery. We hope your courage and strength will be an example to all this Christmas. Child of Bethlehem, draw near.
Child of Bethlehem, hear our prayer.
Thank you. Jesus, help us forgive and be forgiven, to be more accepting of others, and to look for the beauty in our world in order that we might save it. Child of Bethlehem, draw near.
Child of Bethlehem, hear our prayer.
Christmas trees are sparkling and the shops are filled with toys, which will shortly be delivered to happy girls and boys.
Children wait for Santa with his reindeer and his sleigh. Christmas cards are posted, and on Christmas Day there's the opening of the presents and the Christmas games at fun.
But later on at bedtime, when Christmas Day is done, remember how it started with a baby
in the hay, in a manger, in a stable, 2,000 years away.
Long time ago in Bethlehem, so the Holy Bible says, Mary's boy child Jesus Christ was born on Christmas Day. Hark now, hear the angels sing, a king was born. Their flocks by night, they see a bright new shining star. They hear a choir sing a song, the music seems to come from afar. Hark now, hear the angels sing, a king was born today, and man will live forevermore because of Christmas Day. Mary came to Bethlehem that night. They found no place to bear their child, not a single room was inside. Hark now, hear the angels sing, a king was born today, and man will live forevermore because of Christmas Day. Find a little moon in a stable all forlorn, and in a manger cold and dark, Mary's little boy was born. Hark now, hear the angels sing, a king was born today, and man will live forevermore because of Christmas Day.
It was a snowy, moon-filled Christmas Eve night. The house was dark, but for Christmas tree lights. The people within were tucked up in bed, dreaming of the day that lay ahead. Then in front of the fireplace, with a magical glow, Father Christmas appeared and shook off the snow. A mince pie and drink had been left out for him. He took just a little. He was trying to slim. Next to the drink, a letter had been placed. Santa opened it up. And read it with haste.
Dear Santa, all year long we've been very, very good. So please leave us some toys if you could. We would love a doll or two and a cute soft teddy to cuddle you. A magic, a beauty doll and magic rare beauty set. We'd be ever so grateful for all we can get. How about action hero and robot man figures and tabletop soccer, the game you play with your fingers? Last but not least, please can you spare a tablet computer which we all can share? We left you a pie and a Christmas drink too. We hope you enjoy them. Happy
The house was again very dark and peaceful, except for the faint sound of snoring people. And as we all know, between midnight and five, when humans are asleep, toys come alive. One by one, the toys began to stir. They looked around them to see where they were.
Action, you're a toy supervisor, buddy, producer.
I'm Beauty Doll, the most beautiful doll ever made.
I'm Cute Cuddly Teddy, the most huggable teddy in the world.
I'm Robot Girl, the space toy with glasses sound effects.
With introductions over, the toys had begun to enjoy their 5 hours of freedom and fun. First, they examined the room where they were, wondering why they had been left there.
Attention, fellow toys! I think we should explore this place, see where we are and why we're here.
Good idea, but first I need to check myself in the mirror. Mirror, standing tall, who's the prettiest toy of all?
You're most attractive, that is true, with the lovely hair and pretty face too. But without the source you want to win, remember the true beauty lies within.
True beauty lies within, what does that mean? Oh, is it my little China lemon showing?
Beep! Action Zero is right. We need to work out why we are all here.
Your old Christmas present like me.
Who said that?
It's me, the big box over here, wrapped in coloured paper.
What did you say you were? A what present?
A Christmas present. Inside this box is a toy like you, waiting to be opened on Christmas morning.
How come they're after open war locked?
That's because you were brought here by Santa and he didn't have time to wrap you, and I was put here by the grown-ups in the house.
Who is this Santa pussy?
The old man in the red suit who brought you here, remember?
Me? Remember someone wearing red? We don't like people who wear red, do we?
There are two other Christmas presents here, what will help? This is called a tablet computer, what will tell you all the information you're wanting. And this is called a music clip. And it will play some Christmas songs.
Christmas songs, that sounds fun.
The toys began to search the internet for Christmas clues. They learned about Santa, reindeer and snow. They learned about holly and mistletoe. They read about parties, crackers and shopping, Christmas pudding, sweets, turkey and stuffing. But they started to feel a little unease when they got to the part about Christmas trees. For as they compared the computer's description with the tree next to them, they had a big question. For despite looking beautiful with branches of light, there was something about it that didn't seem right.
Something that doesn't seem right.
You ain't skipping over one here, you pet! I'm not made from one. I'm made from plastic, top grade plastic, all the way from Taiwan.
Have a lad, before I get my red card out, I know how to solve this problem. We'll get the computer to tell us all about Christmas trees again and compare it with our tree.
A Christmas tree is usually a tall green pine tree.
Tall green, check!
Presents are placed beneath the tree on Christmas Eve.
Presents, check!
The tree is decorated with lights.
Lights, check!
Finally, the figure is crowned on top of the tree, usually a star or an angel.
What did you say should be there? A star wash?
An angel.
An angel like me? Will you stop screaming?
Leak.
Hello, I'm the angel who lives on top of the tree.
Why are you not up there now?
You tried sitting on a prickly branch all day. love to fly. Whee!
Usually make up the gaze at me. I'll look in your hatch and review what I see.
Wow! A magic mirror 3000. Santa's really gone to town this year.
Mirror, mirror, standing tall, who's the best angel of all? With pushies in and pushies out, you're on the tree. Of that there's no doubt. Now, please help these toys learn the real reason why we celebrate the Christmas season.
What? You don't know the Christmas story?
You're just learning.
You must know that part the angels played in the Christmas story.
You mean the one about Santa and Rudolph?
No, I mean the one about Christ's birth. That's why it's called Christmas. Haven't you noticed Mary and Joseph over there?
Hello.
Hello. Sorry, but none of us have a clue what you're talking about. Please tell us about the Christmas story.
She is going to have a baby named Jesus, and he would be the savior of the world. This is how it came about all those years on the very first Christmas.
One day there was a gathering at the center of the town. The king and his soldiers had to make an important announcement.
Hear ye, hear ye, hear ye. Caesar Augustus, emperor of Rome and ruler of the world, commands that a census be taken so that he may know the number of citizens. You are commanded to go with your family to the town of your birth to sign the register of names. By order, Caesar Augustus.
Hail Caesar!
Now Joseph was in a town miles away from Nazareth. This meant he and Mary had to set off on a long journey to Bethlehem.
It was winter and it was very cold and right in Bethlehem. They had to go going on the streets crowded and all the little folk.
There was no room anywhere and Mary and Joseph were exhausted after their long journey.
Well, here we are at last. You can soon rest, Mary. I'll just wake up the innkeeper. Open up in there. Hurry up, open this door.
What's all this racket? People are trying to sleep in here, you know. What do you want, young man?
On the room for my wife and me. We travelled all the way from Nazareth to register here.
Sorry, we're full up. Every room is taken. You couldn't bring a cat in here, it's so packed. Now, if you'll excuse me, I've work to do.
Listen, we sleep on the floor, in the courtyard, anywhere at all. My wife is with child and she can't spend the night outdoors.
I've already told you we've no room. There are already three families sleeping in each room along with their donkeys and chickens. There are women and children sleeping on every inch of the floor, not to mention the tables. You're too late, you'll have to try elsewhere.
We've tried everywhere else. I'm sick of people telling us to try somewhere else. Why don't you help us instead of giving us useless advice?
Joseph, Joseph, come away. Don't get angry with the gentleman. It can do no good. Besides, it's not his fault there's no room. We are sorry to have disturbed you, sir. My husband meant no harm. He is tired and worried about me. Come along, Joseph.
Wait. Your wife is more polite than you. How young you are. You remind me of my daughter in Caesarea. Listen, son. For her sake, I'll do you a favour. Just outside town, you'll find a small stable. Nothing fancy, but you'll have a roof over your head and plenty of warm straw. Don't make your own an oxen donkey.
We're grateful, sir. You must accept this.
Put away your money, lad. I won't charge you for spending the night in a beast stable. Besides, your wife really does remind me of my daughter. Away with you now.
Thank you, good sir. May God reward your kindness to us. Come along, Joseph.
Now we're in Bethlehem. There are lots of fields where sheep used to graze. The night was cold and the shepherds stuck it in turn to watch over their sheep.
This is what you call a cold night. Wish I was down in the tavern drinking wine instead of freezing on this bleak hillside.
No, no, Isaac. Forget the wine and think of the sheep. It's cold nights like this that the wolves get hungry and come hunting for mutton.
Just be grateful the moon is there, or maybe those wolves will be coming after us. What's that you're singing, Abraham? An alibi for the sheep.
Singing? I wasn't singing. I can't sing.
Maybe he was snoring.
No, listen. It's the most beautiful singing I've ever heard.
God preserve us, you're right. But where is it coming from?
The sky is full of light, as if dawn were breaking.
Look stairs, great multitude from the earth.
It's the end of the world.
The
not be afraid. Listen, I bring news of great joy, a joy to be shared by all people.
Today, Bethlehem, our Savior has been born. To you is Christ the Lord.
Here is a sign for you to go to Bethlehem. There you will find a child wrapped in swaddling clothes and laying in a manger. Go now and don't hesitate.
Are we dreaming?
That was no dream. That was a sign from God that the Messiah has come at last. We must go to Bethlehem to welcome him.
Let's go quickly and heavenly host watch over a sheep till I return.
Just as the angels had said, Jesus had been born in a stable. Mary, his mother, wrapped him up in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger. Mary and Joseph gazed at him with love.
Jesus, the Saviour of the world, is born and is going to be living with them.
They could hardly believe this had happened to them.
Just then, three kings arrived at the stable. They had been travelling for months, following a bright star which had appeared in the sky.
Because they were wise men, they knew that the star was a sign from God that the Son and the Saviour had been born.
Hooray, what do you want?
Be still, Joseph. These men are kings from a far off land. They've come to see the child.
We followed a great and shining star that led us here.
We seek the infant king of the Jews.
We have our gifts for him.
This is the child. His name is Jesus.
Praise the Lord.
Come forward, don't be afraid.
Angels came to us on a hillside and told us we could find a child there.
He told us this is the Messiah.
Come forward, the child in the manger is one angel spoke of.
But we are poor men, we have no gifts for him.
He has come to serve the humble and the poor. He does not need your gifts, only your love.
Come on everyone, give me a hand with you.
It's all making sense now. Is that why humans give presents at Christmas? Because the king brought presents to Jesus.
Yes, but also Jesus was a gift from God to the world. Now that you've discovered the real meaning of Christmas, let's see if there can be some peace here. All you find is happy and more, because it's joy, love, peace, not war.
I think my mother is talking to you.
Me? I'm not made for war. It's just some toys here of inferior quality compared to superior toys like me.
If you're so superior, then the magic mirror look into your heart.
No problem. I have nothing to fear from a toy piece of glass. Near here stands tall. Who's the best quality toy of all?
You should have power, God's good, but quality your heart is very poor. Overpriced with your beauty is always, and to top it up, your product could use your dreadful.
How dare you!
Woken up the humans! Quick, everyone, get back into your places!
I should have done that without here.
Me too. I'm surprised it didn't wake the children up.
As the adults left, they closed the door, meaning the toys could come to life once more. But there was no more squabbling or bickering, as what the toys had heard began to sink in.
That's right, we're all in this together.
Let me give you a big virtual hug.
Get back into your places.